Hey everyone, today we're going to walk through getting started with the Sysdig Secure Essentials platform. In this video, we'll cover how you can get Kubernetes visibility and security insights in 5 minutes or less. We'll be going through the core workflows of image scanning, runtime security, compliance, Kubernetes and container monitoring, and then application and cloud service monitoring as well. Now let's get started with the installation. In a single line command, we can install the agent, which will communicate with the Kubernetes cluster, start the proper RBAC permissions, and then install that agent on every single node in the cluster. As soon as the agent's installed, we'll automatically start scanning all images, discover hundreds of applications, and give you key insights within minutes. As a SaaS platform, this is something you can get started with right away and don't have to worry about installing any backend software within your systems. As you can see, all our agent and image analyzer pods are up and running. And that's it. Now insights will be flowing into the Sysdig platform. So let's go back into the product to check what we're seeing. Let's first start off with some Kubernetes monitoring use cases. I can easily see the specific cluster, the node status, if pods are available, and then drill down into either nodes or namespaces. Let's look at namespaces first. Here I can then see the different namespaces that I have deployed into that cluster, and then drill down into a specific namespace to see the workloads. This will give me an easy view into my different workloads, how they're performing from a network perspective, how they're performing versus limits. Looks like I haven't done a good job setting up my limits for this demo environment here, and get a really nice at-a-glance view of this Kubernetes environment. Now that we've looked at Kubernetes, let's go and focus on an individual application. The Sysdig agent will automatically detect workloads that are running, and then we can look at performance metrics from those applications. So here, let's focus on something like Cassandra, and I'll be able to see things like write requests, read requests, write request latency, CPU usage, and those different types of items in that environment. Now that we've got a good handle from a monitoring perspective, let's go hop over and look at what we can do on the security side. One of the key use cases that everyone starts off with is image scanning. So when the agent is installed, we'll look at all the containers that are running in your environment, and then the image analyzer will analyze those to make sure that they're free of vulnerabilities and evaluate them against the policies. Here we can easily see there's 26 different images that are running in the 3-node GKE cluster. And let's go drill into that specific Cassandra image. When I click on this image, I'll get an at-a-glance view of has it passed its or failed its policy evaluation. Here there's almost 2,000 OS vulnerabilities, 24 non-OS vulnerabilities. And then from a policy perspective, we can go in and see what's causing different stop or warn actions here. So there's no health check within that image, a user hasn't been configured, and then there's a bunch of vulnerabilities with a fix available. So it's gonna be something that's directly actionable for your team. Now let's go look at what we can do from a runtime security perspective. So when you install the Sysdig product, one of the things that we come with out of the box is a set of default policies. By clicking this button here, you'll automatically apply runtime security to your environment, and all of these policies will be pushed to those agents that Mateo installed. Once the policies are created, you can easily scope them to a host, a container, or any other custom tags that you've added to identify your infrastructure. If a policy is triggered, you can then choose to take actions like killing a container, stopping a container, pausing a container, or routing that alert to a specific notification channel of your choosing. Now let's go in and look at some of the different rules that come out of the box that are enforced by policies and how they map to specific compliance standards. I can focus on PCI, for example, and then see the different rules that are mapping to that standard. Looking at a rule, you can also go in and see the individual control that they'd map to. So if a new cluster rule with a wildcard is created, that could put you in violation of section 10.2. Hopefully this gives you a good out-of-the-box view of what Sysdig can provide in 5 minutes or less as soon as you install in your environment. Getting started is quick and easy. All you need to do is visit sysdig.com and fill out the free trial page on our homepage to get started. Looking forward to talking to you soon. Thanks.